YouTube channel Skills to Skill. Listen Mahabharata in simple English by Shruti Bhushan. In the previous video, we have seen that Draupadi was married to 5 Pandavas. We also know about the oath of Pandavas. Today, we will see further. If you haven't watched the previous video, please watch it. And also, like, share and subscribe to Skills to Scale to get more videos. Today, we will see what happened next. Come on, let's start today's video. After the wedding was completed, all the Pandavas along with Draupadi take the blessings of elders. The news that Pandavas are alive and have won the Swayamvar spread everywhere and also reached Hastinapur. Bhishma is delighted upon listening this. He wants the king of Hastinapur back. He orders Vidura to go to Panchal and get Pandavas back. Vidura goes to Panchal and requests all the Pandavas to return back. Pandavas also accept this and all of them return to Hastinapur. Seeing all this, Duryodhana gets angry and requests his father to make him the king. Dhritarashtra, though a little bit disappointed with Duryodhana and other sons for not winning Draupadi's hand, but was happy for Pandavas. He ordered for arrangements to welcome the Pandavas and Draupadi. Worrying about the kingdom on one side and not able to satisfy both Duryodhana and the Pandavas, Dhritarashtra requests Bhishma and Vidura for a solution. Bhishma and Vidura decides that Pandavas should be given a half of their kingdom. Guru Drona also agrees to this proposal as it was the fairest thing to do. When the Pandavas reach Hastinapur, all the people of Hastinapur happily welcome their old king. Pandavas, after returning, sought the blessings of all the elders in the family. Dhritarashtra, Bhishma and Guru Drona tell them that they would separate the kingdom into two and give a half of it to the Pandavas, to which the Pandavas agreed. The Pandavas were given a cursed land called Pandavaprastha, surrounded by Khandav forest. This forest was said to be cursed by Lord Indra to be an infertile land and was inhabited by Nagas, that is snakes and rakshas. The Pandavas asked the help of their cousin Krishna to help set up their capital city. The Khandavaprastha was a half of the place given to Pandavas. The surrounding forest was under the control of Naga ruler Takshna. When the Pandavas along with some people of Hastinapur who wished to live under the rule of Yudhishthir reached Khandavaprastha, Lord Agni, the god of fire, reached out to Krishna and Arjuna to help him devour the forest to satisfy his hunger. They agreed to help Lord Agni since it would be a great chance for them to set up the capital city in that land. Since it is a land cursed by Indra, they were sure that Indra would try to protect the forest. Arjuna asked Lord Agni to give him proper weapons to combat with Indra easily. Agni called Varuna, the water god, and asked him to give Arjuna the Gandiva, the most powerful bow and an inexhaustible set of arrows. The Khandava forest was then burnt by wildfires from Agni. Most of the inhabitants, mainly the Nagas and Rakshas, were killed. Takshaka fled to Takshila. Learning about this, Lord Indra was very angry with Arjuna and Krishna for helping Lord Agni to destroy the forest and started to fight with them. As we know, Lord Indra is father of Arjuna. Now, how will a son fight against his father? To know what happened next, please watch my next video. If you liked the story and felt it interesting, click on the like button. Do share to your friends and let them know about Mahabharata in simple English. Do subscribe for more updates.